apostle, glory to God, Bailey, Lady Bailey, Pastor, glory to God, we thank God for Pastor and Mother Hayes. Let's give her a great big hand clap.
Amen.
We really do appreciate all of you, all of my lovely wife, amen, and Lady Bailey, all the ministers, amen. I'm not going to be before you long, but there is a word from the Lord. I didn't say there is a word from the Lord.
There is a word from the
Lord. You know, the Lord spoke to me. We all know the scripture. We want to go to Isaiah, glory to God, 61. Isaiah, the first verse, we're going to read from Isaiah 61. And then we're going to skip over after we read Isaiah 61. We're going to go to, glory to God, Luke 4:18. Amen. How many people are glad that Jesus woke you up this morning? How many people are glad that, you know, you woke up in your right mind? Somebody woke up in a crazy house. Somebody, glory to God, didn't get to wake up. Amen. Somebody died from a car wreck. Somebody died, glory to God, thinking that they was going to be able to celebrate another year and just died suddenly. So it is a privilege and an honor for us to be in the house of the Lord. David said that he'd rather be in the house of the Lord to be any other place. Amen. But it reads in Isaiah 61, I'm coming from the Amplified Version. The Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed and commissioned me to bring good news to the humble and the afflicted. He has sent me to bind up the wounds of the broken heart, to proclaim release from confinement and condemnation, to the physical and spiritual captives, and freedom to prisoners, to proclaim the favorable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance and retribution of all our God, to comfort all who mourn, to grant to those who mourn in Zion the following, to give them a turban instead of dust on their head, a crown of mourning, the oil of joy instead of mourning, the garment of expression praise instead of disheartened spirit, so they will be called the trees of righteousness, strong and magnificent, distinguished for integrity, justice, right standing with God, the blessing of the Lord, that he may be glorified. Look to your neighbor and shout, neighbor,
neighbor,
I don't know what you come to do, but I come to praise the Lord. Say that one more time, I come to praise the Lord. You know, the reason that we are here to praise the Lord is simply because the scripture says, glory to God, that when Paul and Silas, they was in prison, we understand that it was at midnight they began to pray and the prison walls began to fall. Not only that, but the Bible says in Judges, the Bible says, glory to God, that the children of Israel, they was in war, and the Bible says that God began to use the prophet and said, I want you to get the ministers together. I want you to get the army together, get the praise and worship together, and set an atmosphere, because we're going to shoot an arrow into Brooklyn. And I want you to understand, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the reason that we are here today is simply because the grace and favor of God. I want you to understand that grace is the ability, the strength. It is the divine strength from God. See, grace don't come from, glory to God, just anywhere. But grace comes from up on high. The Bible says in Ephesians 1 and the 3rd verse, the Bible says that we was blessed with all spiritual blessings and heavenly places. Look to your neighbor and shout, neighbor, heavens have came to invade this place. Heaven has come to invade this place. Yes, how do I know? Because the Bible says in 1 John 4:4, the Bible declares, greater is he that's in you than he that is in this whole world. First of all, I want you to understand that is talking about the dunamis power, the inner power. It's talking about the grace of God. It's talking about the grace that Paul began to talk about. I want you to understand the reason that you're saved is not, glory to God, because you said, yes, Lord. The reason you're saved because what Christ did. The Bible said, glory to God, that Jesus had to come, and he had to come for all of our sins. Glory to God. Paul said it best. He said, oh, wretched man. He said, when I want to do good, he said, evil is always present. The Bible said it went about trying to establish their own righteousness. He said, but then you know what? They have knowledge, but not according to the will of God. The truth of the matter is that you're not saved, glory to God, because your mom, your cousin, your brother, your sister. But we are saved because of Jesus. Look to your neighbor and shout, neighbor. Glory to God, that's why you don't have to, glory to God, look at yourself and try to measure yourself according to the things that you do. Because he said on the cross, it was finished. Look to your neighbor and shout, neighbor. Glory to God, it's a finished work. And you are a byproduct. The truth of the matter is that a lot of times, glory to God, we think that praying is going to do it. We think fasting is going to do it. But you know, he told the disciples, he said there's a season where the disciples, they can fast. He said, but long as I'm here, they can't fast. And I want you to understand that Christ that worketh in you and live in you, the hope of glory. Glory to God, sometimes you don't have to, glory to God, pray long prayers. You just pray according to your faith. And it be done. I want you to understand, ladies and gentlemen, that a lot of times we go through our types of emotional warfare. I didn't say emotional warfare. Emotional warfare is where you're trying to put everything collective together in your mind. Glory to God, what do you mean? You woke up, you didn't have your medicine. You woke up, you didn't have your dentures. You woke up, you didn't have your glasses. You woke up, you didn't have no money. You woke up, had a little pain in your body. You woke up, forgot to call somebody. You woke up, glory to God, felt like, glory to God, giving up. Woke up, glory to God, not feeling like, glory to God, all jolly in the spirit. And the reason why you felt like that is because the Bible says, in the book of Revelation, the 12th chapter, the Bible declares that Satan is the accuser of the brethren day and night. Look to your neighbor and shout, neighbor.
Neighbor.
The reason why that you're feeling fatigued, because there's a devil on your way. And the truth of the matter is, that's why we come together to fellowship. I dare to say fellowship. Glory to God. The truth of the matter is to get strength. Me and my wife, we was watching a video last night, and I said, you want to know the difference between 20 years and now? 20 years ago, glory to God, you couldn't pay nobody to miss God because they knew nothing but God. They brought their homework to church. Come on now. Kids didn't have no curfew because they woke up in the church and they was going to school. Come on now. The truth of the matter is we had shut-ins. Not only that, but the truth of the matter is that, glory to God, sometimes you had 3-4 services and nobody wasn't worried about time because the only thing they was thinking about is getting closer to Jesus. And the truth of the matter is now we have replaced praise, glory to God, authentic testimony with showing entertainment. People begin to, glory to God, try to show you what they were, try to out-preach one another, try to out-prophesy one another, try to, glory to God, call out names and call out everybody's names, but not living according to the name of Jesus. But he said, glory to God, that everybody would know you by the love that you have for one another. I have noticed that a lot of times people begin slow, they begin low, just like Saul. The scripture says, glory to God, the Bible says that David, he was humble, but the prophet Nathan came to him and said, you know what, you was doing good until you became big in your own eyes. Look to your neighbor and shout, neighbor. You got to humble yourself. You got to humble yourself. Because the truth of the matter is that we all need God. The reason why Brother Haynes and this prophet of the nations, and glory to God, this prophetess is here, it's because she heard the voice of the Lord. Even though her husband left, she said, I must be about my father's kingdom business. Glory to God, she said, I got to see the king. And the truth of the matter is that a lot of times, people are now in this time, when they come to church, they want to know who I'm programming. Not only that, but they want to know who's preaching. They want to know who's singing. If they don't sing their favorite song, then they ain't went to church. But glory to God, tried Jesus, and he was not right. People were against him. When they got to purge, and people were beginning to be filled with the Holy Spirit. People used to come to the altar saying, yes, Lord. Yes, to your way. Yes, to your will. Yes, I will obey. It didn't take a whole bunch of gimmicks and games to get people to skills. But now we're living in an hour of social media where people think that the preacher, whether God is their home or home girl, if you will. So people have lost respect for the pulpit. We have people, glory to God, they have a split from generations to revelation. You can see everything. They ain't saving nothing. Glory to God. But the truth of the matter is that God is looking for a people that are holy. Glory to God. Because he said he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle or blemish or any such thing. Look at your neighbor and shout, neighbor. It's not your holiness, but it's the holiness of God.
It's not your holiness, but the holiness of God.
So the truth of the matter is, I found out that in Matthew 24, the Bible says that there will be many people that say that they're Christ. Christ represents the anointed one. It represents the person that has been anointed, glory to God, for a set time. When you get the word kairos, I never say kairos. Kairos means appointed time. When you found that in Acts 1 and 5. So you got chronos, which is man's time, and you got kairos. You must understand Ecclesiastes, the third chapter of the Bible, declares that he says that there's a certain time and a season under the heaven. See, heaven don't go by time, they set time. But the earth, and the Bible says that the stars, he says the sun and the moon were set for a certain time and season. So the truth of the matter is, and I want you to understand that when he was talking about that, he was talking about the second heaven. The reason why I'm saying this is because the church is off time. We'll still fight with one another when people are dying. We'll still fight with one another because we didn't get to do our favorite song or our favorite this or our favorite that when somebody has killed your loved one.
Yes.
And the reason why the enemy has crept in is because somebody ain't been praying no more. Yeah. The truth of the matter is, the Bible says that my house shall be called a house of what?
Worship.
And the truth of the matter is that we don't want to pray no more because the youth, they say it's boring, it's outdated. But I'm here to tell you why so many young people are dying now. It's because they ain't been praying. See, the truth of the matter is the difference between the youth, glory to God, and the elderly is that the youth is trying to figure it out when the elderly has already been there and done that. And the truth of the matter is that the young people are fighting the older people because they think, glory to God, they can teach them something new. And the older people are fighting with the young people because they're trying to get them mature. So what's happening is there is, glory to God, a spiritual invasion. But the Bible says, glory to God, I believe in the book of John, the Bible says that the spirit of Elias, that's talking about, glory to God, Christ, the anointing, was going to bring and draw all men back. Matter of fact, it says in Joel, because we must understand that glory to God in Joel, Ezekiel prophesied about the exile, about how that they was going to, glory to God, be destroyed, and how so much judgment was going to come. He was a judgment prophet. And the truth of the matter is, we're living in an hour where people are trying to bully God's people, which is the children of Israel. But God said, glory to God, and he was going to gather all the nations. He said, all them that have scattered my people. He said, and I'm going to gather them in one place. And that place is called Jehoshaphat. He said, glory to God, and when I bring them back, he says that he was going to make a plea for his people. So this is what's going on. Some people say, glory to God, have you seen the tornadoes on the news? Why we seeing so much nuclear war? Why we seeing so many plane crashes? The Bible says, we're not through the 24th chapter. The Bible says, he said, woe unto them that give flight in those things. Before then, there was no jets that was made. Before then, there was no airplanes that was made. But Jesus knew everything. So he said, Paul roars. Glory God, the Bible says that the brother was going to come against the brother. We're living in an hour, glory God, where it seems like you can wake up 1 minute, somebody praying, and the next day it seems like you never knew him, because there's so much hell that broke loose. This is just prophecy been fulfilled. He said, not one jot or tittle shall be broken. He said, glory God, heaven and earth shall pass away. He said, but my word shall not pass away. The truth of the matter is, he said, the flower, it will wither away. The grass, it will fade away. But it's the word of God that shall abide forever. And the truth of the matter is, the reason why, glory God, you feel so weak in your body, as the elect lady said, the elect bell said, she said, glory to God, because Sunday school does something to you. Let me tell you something. Sweet Judge Brown feeds your flesh, but glory to God, this word feeds your spirit, man. See, the truth of the matter is, David said it like this. He said, my foot almost slipped, but it was the word of God that strengthened me and keep me from, glory to God, falling and slipping and slumbering. The truth of the matter is, the reason why the enemy wants for you to get bored and fatigued when it comes down to the things of God, because I'm going to break it down. And John ruined Jesus is, glory to God, his definition is the light of the world. John 2, he's showing, glory to God, that he's a miracle worker. John 3, he comes to show that he's the savior of the world. John 4, he comes to show that he's the restorer of the world. John 5, he comes, glory to God, to show that he's your healer. John 6, he comes to, glory to God, show that he's that latter rain, and so on. And the truth of the matter is that a lot of times we come to church thinking that Jesus is just a homeboy. And how do I know? Because we'll try Jesus and have a Tylenol right next to us. We'll try Jesus and have, glory to God, a lawyer. But they used to say that Jesus is my lawyer. Jesus is my doctor. Jesus is my keeper. Jesus is my strong tower. Jesus is a friend that's sitting closer than any brother. Jesus is a rock. Glory to God. Jesus, glory to God, is my keeper. Jesus, glory to God, is my shield and buckler. Jesus is my helmet and salvation. But we don't hear them testimonies no more. We want to know why. Because we are so much social media driven. We are so trend on trends and fashion, hot topics. The church became like a church that, glory to God, Saul led. You want to know what happened when Saul led the church? You want to know why he disobeyed God? You want to know why, glory to God, he failed God? Because he said, the people told me to do this. The truth of the matter is, you can serve God and serve man. He said, love God with all your heart. Love him with everything within you. He said, anything you find your hands to do, he said, do it with all your heart, all your soul. Glory to God, the truth of the matter is, my great uncle, glory to God, he preached so that, glory to God, after he preached, he laid hands and went to glory. Glory to God, because he was determined that, glory to God, if he had to die, let him die the death of Christ. And a lot of people, glory to God, they're dying, glory to God, over baby mamas, dying over, glory to God, drugs, and dying over this and that, things that don't even matter. But it's time for us to become sold out. God is calling the third tower. He's calling the church back, glory to God, to the horns of the altar. The truth of the matter is, what's happening spiritual is that the church has lost her identity. The Bible says in the last day, the Bible said Revelation, the Bible said, glory to God, that you are going to either be lukewarm or cold. He said, glory to God, if you be lukewarm, I'm going to spit you out. And we're living in an hour where people are jumping, trying to bend over the fence. 1 minute they saved, and 1 minute you can tell if they saved no more. The reason why, because they don't have what Isaiah declared. They don't have the true spirit of God. But when you have the spirit of God, even when you're going through a depression, even when you're going through mental hurt, even when you're going through self-affliction, you're Lord of God, that the anointing comes. Lord of God, you want to know what happens when you get the anointing? The people that you say that you love, they turn on you. The people that you grew up with, Lord of God, they turn on you. You want to know what happens when the anointing comes? Lord of God, attacks come. You want to know why attacks come? Because he said this suffering that you go through is not worthy to the glory that shall be compared. Lord of God, you're going through all types of storms. That's because God is molding and shaping you. That's because there are communities inside of you. That's because, glory to God, not communities, but nations inside of you.
Yes.
And the truth of the matter is that we say that I want to be saved. We want to be saved long as we're not tried in any way. The Bible says that the rich man, he came to Jesus, a young rich man. He said, give up everything you have. We're living in this generation where they call preachers pimps now.
Yeah.
When you say give anything, they say you're a pimp. But see, the truth of the matter is that, glory to God, they don't trip about paying $300 for a weave. They don't pay, glory to God, they don't trip about, glory to God, going to go buy the newest iPhone. But when it comes down to sowing into the house of God, they get mad. You want to know why? Because the enemy has took their eyes on off the reason, the true purpose. People have come to house. They say, you know what? The church is just money on their burgers. They don't understand that the church is trying to get something to them. They try, glory to God, and the truth of the matter is that people, glory to God, they have tried to shut preachers down. Glory to God, by saying, glory to God, if you do this, glory to God, then I'm going to tell this, I'm going to expose you. But the truth of the matter is, the Bible says that you're a new creature in Christ. So you know what you tell that old devil when they try to tell you, glory to God, that you did this, you did that. You say, I may have did that, but I thank God for the blood. Because the blood was shed for the remission of sin. I thank God for the blood. Turn.
Turn from doubt. Turn from glory, God. Self-righteousness. What do you mean? Everything that we've been taught sometimes it be wrong. The reason why it be wrong, because sometimes people mean good. I never had a three-year-old. Let me tell you about a story. You know how people play fight? Glory, God, I was 5 years old. And my uncle, he was playing with this guy. And you know, he was playing. So I got a big, huge prick, and I threw it at him and broke his nose. And my uncle said, "What did you do?" My intention was to protect my uncle, but little did I know that I made the situation worse. This is what happens. Glory to God, when you don't understand that sometimes, glory to God, people mean good, they mean well, but glory to God, because the Bible says they don't have a whole understanding. Everything. And this is why, glory to God, we have to, glory to God, really know God for ourselves. Glory to God, we got to shut ourselves in the door. We got to turn off the TV. Come on now. We got to put aside the plan. Come on now. We got to, glory to God, call for a sympathy. We got to call for a friend. Glory to God, we got to tell glory to God. I'm spouses sometimes. I know you love all this goodness, but it's the goodness of the Lord going to keep you. And if you want glory to God to keep me around, you're going to have to leave me alone for a little bit. So the truth of the matter is that glory to God, you got to set yourself apart. Paul says you got to beat your body. You see the name and say, beat your body. Beat your flesh. What does that mean? That means when your stomach goes to grind it, you say, oh, it ain't time to eat. Glory to God, when your head start hurt, you say, oh, I line up with the word of God. When your back start hurt, your knees start shaking, you say, it's the month of the show, the Lord. Line up. Because glory to God, you understand that you're going after something. Because I will understand that we're living in perilous and evil days and evil times. We're glory to God, people trying to sway people from the truth. This is why, glory to God, the church is empty. Because we think that church is supposed to be dim light. We think church is supposed to be glory to God. Where people, glory to God, be dancing. Glory to God, and doing all types of stuff. But ain't living holy. But I want you to understand that there are always a false move before there's a real move. Listen to your neighbor and shout, neighbor. But now this is the time for the real true sons of God to arise. Holies of holies. It was the priest, Lord of God, that could go before God. See, the truth of the matter is, Lord of God, the church, they will be shut out for 7 days. Why the priest will have to go in? For it's a privilege that we're able to come to church and to the house of God. But the truth of the matter is, we think, Lord of God, because we woke up this morning, put on our Sunday's best, that we give God a favor. When the truth of the matter is, it's the grace of God that you bring in here. Because some people have been raped, some people have been beaten, some people have, Lord of God, passed through the fire.
But I plead the blood of Jesus. And I told my
say, you know what? I say, you may want to act like this, but God has a purpose in you. And one day, glory to God, he heard the voice of the Lord. He couldn't find it no more. He was drunk, and God changed his heart. I want you to know that God is the same God of yesterday. I know that people, glory to God, don't believe that he's a deliverer. The Bible says to remind me of my word.
Yes.
Look to the neighbor and say, have you reminded him?
Not
complaining like the children of Israel. Yes. They were swallowed up by earthquake because they complained, murmured, and complained. They didn't understand who God was. Don't be like the children of Israel. Don't be like the new church, glory to God, that followed Jesus. And he fed them, glory to God, with 5 loaves of fish and bread. And they didn't understand that he was, glory to God, greater than their situation. Don't be like the disciples that look at the storm and think the storm is greater than Jesus when you're on the ship with Jesus.
Yes.
What happens is life gets us sometimes. This is why we got to make a vow to the Lord.
Yes.
That, glory to God, not only we won't turn back, but we're going to be submissive to this mighty man of God. This mighty man of God and this woman of God and this prophetess of the nations. Hallelujah. We got to make a vow to the Lord that, glory to God, no matter what's going on, see, sometimes we check in on Facebook. We check in on Instagram. We check in on social media, but we don't check in with God and his people. And we're trying to figure out why we're so weak, why we're so hurt, why we're so confused, why this happened, why that happened. Because the truth of the matter is, let me tell you something, that you can never be warm with somebody that's colder than you. You got to come where the fire is at. You got to come where the lunatic is at. You got to come where the word is being preached. You got to come where the people are lifting up Jesus. That's why we got to encourage people. You know, we don't get embarrassed when we sit. The Bible says the afflictions. He says that we don't go through a many afflictions. He says, but the Lord will deliver us. It's just the scripture being fulfilled. And guess what? Sometimes you might have a cold, you might have a sickness. You know, we give the doctors more credibility than God. You know, we say, well, the doctor healed me. You know, when God is the one that created the herbs and the ground that the doctors use, yeah. God is the one that formed man. God is the one that created everything.
Yeah.
And we give man the credibility and we overlook God. But God said to somebody in here today, somebody been mad at God. They've been mad at God. They say, you know what? If he was God, why you do this? Let me tell you something. My granddad, Queen Esther Jones, my granddad, David Sr., had died of a heart attack. My grandmother, she died of cancer. My other granny died of cancer. My other grandma died right in my face. My uncle died from a stroke. My auntie died from an aneurysm. Back to back to back. My cousin died from sickle cell. My god sister died from a bullet, a stray bullet. You see what I'm saying? I was mad at God, but I wasn't foolish. I said, God, why am I going through all this? It seems like everybody I'm connected to has been under attack. Seems like everything that I have trusted you for, seems like everything is going backwards. How many people pay tithes? And when you pay tithes, it looks like nothing ain't happened. You want to know why? Because God is saying, I want to see if I can trust you in your heart. Because see, sometimes we do it out of tradition, but we don't do it out of purpose.
Yes.
Let me say it again.
Yes.
So, in other words, we're doing it because we're taught to do it, but he says you be obedient and willing. Because we're doing it out of obedience, but not because we're willing to do it.
Right.
We're just doing it because we were told to do it,
right,
and not because we was willing to do it.
Right.
So, God had to tell me, he said, son, he said, everything that you have belongs to me. Everything. Your life belongs to me. Matter of fact, my wife don't know this. All week, I have been going through a sickness in my body. The enemy tried to kill me. He told me earlier this morning in prayer, he said, I want to kill you. He said, but there's purpose on your life, and God said, I can't kill you. You must understand that the enemy, the only reason that you're not dead is because the grace of God is on your life.
Yes, yes.
But somebody is waiting for you. The only reason this is not a casket with your name on it is because of purpose on your life.
Yes, yes.
The only reason why the curse didn't work with a witch trying to put something on you is because there's purpose on your life.
Yes.
The only reason that you didn't take that pill and overdose because there was purpose on your life. The only reason that you didn't go crazy when you knew that they cheated on you, lied on you, said they was going to do what you could have and went with somebody else because there's purpose on your life. The reason that we're still here today is because purpose. Everybody, if we can understand, I believe there's three people that need to say yes to God all over again. Because these three people prophetically have family that they've been looking for God to move suddenly. And the Spirit of the Lord said, that don't be ashamed. I heard the pastor say, I love standing in the gap. That's what an intercessor does. And I want you to understand, the reason that pastor goes through so much warfare is because an intercessor goes through warfare. They're taking on the punches and the blows of your stuff. They're really supposed to be people fighting for the pastor. And a first lady, a lit lady, standing in the gap. Because long as Moses' hand was stood up, and long as they held the hand up with Moses, they seen the victory.
Yeah.
You should not depend on your leader to do everything. It's some things that you got to grow up and you got to do. So God says, three people. There are three people. Everybody, if you can, you just bow your hands. You can lift up your hands. If you say, I'm that third person, I want to be that person for my family. I want you to lift up your hands. There's somebody that needs a healing in their body. There's a deliverance that needs to take place. Lift up your hands. Because I see in the spirit realm. Thank God, I see one. There's another. The reason why is because the Bible says where two or three are gathered in his name, but he is in the midst of them. If everybody could come up here to the altar, I want to speak a prophetic blessing over you. Before my grandmother passed, at the age of four, Queen Esther Jones, the best Queen Esther Jones, she laid hands on me. And I went to sleep and I seen angels, I seen heaven. I done seen the Lord over a dozen of times. The Lord has shown me the disciples. I have seen end time events. Before President Trump came to the office, God showed me he was going to be the president and so many other things. The tornadoes and the hurricanes you have seen is on YouTube. God had me to prophesy these things. God shows me things before they happen. I want to touch you and agree with you concerning your situation. If y'all would come up and meet me at the altar, everybody, if you could meet me at the altar. Hallelujah. 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 Was deaf in their ear, they couldn't hear. How many people have there been this year? About seven people
It was a devil. It was a God. They said something blew his ear out. He couldn't hear him. God gave him his hearing back. It was a person that had cataracts, couldn't see. They received their sight. I don't know if y'all know if they church got a cross too, that had this Pastor Thomas. What's the name? Ben and Ray Thomas. Yeah. For our boy church got a cross. He couldn't hear out his spirit. We did a church service over there, and his spirit opened up in front of him and life. Having people that let him shout out.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
There was a person that had a bullet in their back. They closed in the middle of the service. I'm telling you what God can do. Not what I can do, but what God can do. What Jesus can do. Anything that you need, I want you to put it in the atmosphere. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Anything you want. I had a cousin that the Lord said that he was going to make him a millionaire. And what happened is that he lived in North Carolina. He drives trucks. He said, I'm tired of driving for people. He said, I believe there's more because I want to enjoy my family. He said, I want to be with my family driving trucks. I'll never be able to enjoy my wife for my kids. I said, well, man of God, we're going to believe God. As you obey the word of the Lord, God is going to bless you. Long story short, he said, before the end of this year, I want you to know he sold 10 shirts that was worth $100,000. He's a millionaire that any of people working for. Anything you want, hold on a second. Hold on a second. Because the Bible says that Jesus became poor so that through him, we may become what? Rich. Right? I'm going to tell you something that God spoke to me in the midst of the devil saying what he said to me. He said, the reason why I want to kill you, he said, because I don't want you to get this message out to the church. I said, keep on talking. And the Spirit of the Lord said, the reason why the devil is fighting you, he knows that when the Spirit, the true Spirit of the Lord comes, the Bible says that what? There's what? Liberty, right? Not only that, but the Bible says that debt is paid, right? Hold on a second. The enemy wants us to shout and dance, to speak in tongues, shout and dance, and feel a temporary healing, but never receive the blessing, the whole blessing. When Jesus was healing people, he said, be what? Hold. You didn't catch that. The truth of the matter is, the Bible says Jesus was preaching the gospel to the poor. The reason he was preaching it to the poor, because he wanted them to hear the word so that through him they may become rich. Joseph was prosperous. Abraham was prosperous. Isaac was prosperous. The prophets, the reason they weren't prosperous is simply because, glory to God, they was in the battlefield. But some of them was prophets. And God spoke to me. He said, son, he said, tell my people that they don't have to go from paycheck to paycheck. They don't have to go from a fixed income. Come on now. I don't hear nobody. Lord and God, you don't have to worry about, Lord and God, where your money is going to come from. God said he knows where you live. He's going to send money. Lord and God, how many people believe that? Because see, I'm going to show you some. Acts 1, they waited on the Holy Ghost. Acts 2, the Holy Ghost failed. Acts 3, the power of God was shown. Acts 3 through 4, the Bible says they were so prosperous that they were sharing land. You call that land. Which means, glory to God, that the favor of God was so great, the anointing boosts to get stuff into your hands. Not just for you, but for your whole family. Beyonce, we talk about Beyonce, but they sowing millions of dollars, and I can show you how prophetic that they're walking. They walk in prophetic, and we are not. The Bible says, one more thing, the Bible says that you shall be leaders to nations, not to just people, but nations. I want to pray with you because there's anointing with you.
You, where did you say you was last weekend?
In Paris.
I got family in Paris. Paris, Texas? I got family in Paris. There's a lot of people over in Paris. I do revivals out there. Hallelujah. Dear Heavenly Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I want to pray with this mighty woman of God, this prayer warrior. This woman that has been going through cycles. This one, Ula, Papa, La Tene, that goes Ranchi Vidianta. Tika, Papa, Papa. The enemy has literally been trying to frustrate you. You've been saying, God, I want to grow in you. I want for you to become my everything. I don't want for nobody to come in my space because I've given so many people time and they have used my time and it seems like they don't value my time. Hallelujah. So many people have come in your life and said what they were going to do for you and never did it. I see you with a giving heart, always trying to do, even when you don't know what to do. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost says, he says his hand is on your life. He says, okay. He says, it's okay. He says, it's okay. He says he's going to work miracles for you. There are things that you have been waiting for. He says he's going to release for you. I see release coming over you. I see angels coming. I see angels coming. Hallelujah, there are angels coming. There are angels coming. The enemy desires to